How to perform an out-of-body experience, the basic first step. You are already performing astral projection or an out-of-body experience every time you are asleep. But you remember the out-of-body experience as a dream. To be able to encounter an out-of-body experience is to become conscious while dreaming. This is known as lucid dreaming. In other words, you have to be in control of your dreams. How do you get that right? When you dream you are flying, your sleeping soul has most probably ejected out of your physical body. You must practice to become consciously awareness during your nightly astral projections, which can be done through meditation. The best tool to be able to correctly perform astral projection is training the mind through meditation. During meditation, you must tell your mind or yourself that nothing is impossible and that a conscious out-of-body encounter is indeed possible. You must believe astral projection and travel is indeed possible. Your subconscious mind is listening eye and will carry out what you desire. Your subconscious mind is your doorway to the seemingly unknown and is the bridge between you and your soul. Didn't you ever dream you stood in front of the door in your room, but couldn't get through, because the door was closed? You were unable to go through the door, because you believed you could not. But the reality is, once you are outside your body as a sleeping soul, the material environment does not affect you. In one of my astral travels, I wanted to open the door to my room to wash my face, but when I tried to open the door by turning the handle, my hand went right through the handle. Because I have had countless out-of-body encounters, I instinctively knew I was able to walk right through the door. But you will get to that stage through practice. First of all, you could start getting an out-of-body experience by laying on your bed and closing your eyes as you would before falling asleep. The difference is, you are now going to see yourself getting out of your body willfully. The best way to get that right is to develop an intense desire to reach for something or go somewhere. Or if you intensely long to be with someone, then consider going to that person you love so much with your out-of-body soul. You can also picture yourself climbing up a piece of rope while you are in the process of falling asleep. I want to quickly explain how falling asleep works before we further discuss the probability of getting outside your physical body. Before you doze off into sleep, your subconscious brain instructs your brain to switch on the instruction of the sleep process by releasing a chemical into your blood that would put you to sleep. Your subconscious mind never falls asleep. It does what you believe. And if you start telling yourself you are going to start experiencing conscious lucidity, your subconsciousness will then start to rewire itself accordingly and even rewire your brain. Amazing, is it not? So, firstly, you will have to prepare yourself mentally through regular meditation and repeatedly telling yourself your intention is to become lucid while sleeping. In other words, you will wake up inside your dream state. Practice makes perfect, and you will begin to realize soon there will come improvements into the feat of lucidity. Bear in mind, you are out of your body every time you are asleep. So you do not have to try and get out of your body, because it is already happening. An out-of-body projection of your soul is a natural phenomena. The issue is you are attempting to become conscious while in the dream state. It is indeed highly likely you will get it right. The Buddhist adepts of Tibet are masters at astral projection because practicing astral travel is very much part of their spiritual training and religious devotion. Willful and conscious astral travel has been occurring for centuries already. Secondly, you will have to be completely relaxed. Some people trying to obtain the out-of-body encounter relax themselves through soothing and beautiful music. But people are different, and you can decide for yourself what suits you best in order to become completely relaxed. In my own case, I don't make use of anything. The only thing I find crucial is to be completely at ease, relaxed and with zero distractions. I do not succeed all the time. I would say out of 10 attempts I would get it right once or not at all. Most times I do not succeed, but I do get it right once or twice a month. So do not get disheartened. My email is below.